few days ago I was in like a coffee place, and just going to get a coffee. I was lost in London, I didn't know where I was going, and my music was playing on the system, and you're there kind of asking for directions. It's just funny. It's funny hearing your own music as a soundtrack to your day. I'm a singer-songwriter, influenced and informed by a lot of blues music and gospel music and soul and a bit of folk as well. There's quite a lot of Irish in it, I suppose, or Irish influence in it. So certainly lyrically, more so than anything else. There's a few songs, I suppose, where kind of blues folk and kind of Irish folk meet. I wasn't raised with traditional Irish music as a background. It wasn't blues music was, so I listened to a lot of blues music as a young kid. There's a lot of things about folk, traditional Irish folk music that I do love and I really, really appreciate it. Most of all, I think the kind of stories that they tell, and I suppose that's what I love about songs. My lover's got humor. I can only kind of write what I connect with and what I feel strongly about, I suppose, or what moves me. Take me to church, I worship like a dog at the shrine of your life. Take Me to Church would certainly be an example of lyrics that are influenced by being Irish. The song kind of reflects on a frustration with references the Catholic Church, the way they view sex or sexual orientation, the way they've institutionalized gender inequality. If I wasn't from Ireland, I wouldn't write that song. I've been very, very fortunate that the audiences have been amazing everywhere. Everyone who aspires to be a musician wants to be successful, wants a lot of people to hear their music. Thank you, EBBA, for the award. It's amazing, especially like since the first show was at Eurosonic, and then that's where it's presented, so that's kind of cool. Every day with someone new.